Welcome back to Leeds Lately. Today's video is, of course, a match reaction to Leeds losing 1-0 to Burnley. Make sure you go ahead and hit that big red button down below. Leeds have just lost 1-0 to Burnley in a game that is so frustrating. It makes me go, why do we watch football? You can be the better team throughout a game and just lose. And it's very disappointing. Look, Leeds weren't amazing, but they were still the better team over Burnley in this game. We had a chance, 20, 30 seconds in? Estev, their centre-back, fell over. Mateo Joseph threw on goal. You think, okay, yeah, one good thing about Mateo Joseph, not the one good thing, but one good thing about him, is he can finish. Slots it past the post, wide. Then you've got Nonto's chance where Aronson threaded him through on goal, hit it straight at Trafford. Ampadu shot from the edge of the box. Solomon was fouled inside the box, which was a penalty but wasn't picked up on. Refereeing, again, very poor. Leeds set themselves up in the first half, or Farker set Leeds up in the first half to succeed. And we should have been 3-1 up at halftime. And the second half wouldn't have mattered so much because we didn't do very well in the second half. We didn't particularly manage to create much. Would have been fine because we'd have already been 3-1 up in the first half. So that's your issue, really. We can't score. We can't take our chances. And what happens when they get a chance? Solomon falls over, slips over on the floor. Nobody can get back in time. They've got Cole Osho on one side and Jaden Anthony on the other. And you've got Jaden Bogle is the only person back, caught in two minds. If he goes to Cole Osho, he's just going to pass it across to Jaden Anthony. He's going to be one-on-one. If he goes to Jaden Anthony, he's allowing Cole Osho to go straight at the goal. So he has to kind of split the difference. And then once the player's made their decision, he has to try and then get across. It wasn't quick enough and the ball was shot through his legs into the goal. Very clinical finish from Cole Osho. And that's them then won the game. And it's like, well, surely we can finish some of the chances that were created. I thought Brendan Aaronson was really good and I don't know why on earth he was taken off. Look, the substitutions that I said that should have been made was you bring on Alton Ackett in midfield for either Gruev or Ampadu. Probably Ampadu in this case because he'd picked up that injury in the first half. And I think the reason you do that is you bring on Alton Ackett because he's somebody who can make those third man runs, like I talked about in my preview, to try and open up more space for Joseph because he wasn't getting much service. The second one is to bring on Larji Ramazani earlier in the game and for Solomon, because when Ramazani came on, he looked dynamic, he looked quick, he looked like he was going to properly carry the ball for us, drive us up the pitch. But he wasn't able to do that very much because he only had, 10, 15 minutes to do so. Solomon came off far too late for that decision to happen. When the subs were made, it was Rothwell came on and Pirou came on, two of the players that nobody was asking for. I don't know why he brought those two on. Pirou came on in the number 10 for Aronson, who brings us full circle to the start of this little tangent. Brendan Aronson was our creative number 10. He's the guy who's making things happen. Joel Pirou is not that player. We've said before, it's not Joel Pirou's fault, but that is not the guy he is. That is not the type of player he is. So why do we as a club keep forcing him into that position when it doesn't work? Mateo Joseph, I thought, was okay. He had that snapshot from the edge of the box, which Trafford saved. Let's be honest, Trafford had a good game as well. Look, people saying Trafford had a really good game. A lot of the things that we put at him were very savable. The first one, of course, he spread himself well and Mateo Joseph missed the target completely, but Joseph should have lifted it over him. The second one, Nonto shot it straight at his chest. The third one and the fourth one, Ampadu's shot and Gruev's shots and Mateo Joseph's shots, they were very savable, I think. Mateo Joseph's one was a good save, a decent save. I don't think it was anything spectacular. But Leeds just don't take their chances. They don't put it either side of the goalkeeper, they put it at the goalkeeper. And then we also have things not going against, not going our way, like our chances to win a penalty. And just the way that things are dropping just doesn't seem to go. I mean, in the game, I think we had around 75% possession for pretty much the entire thing. We had 17 shots, four of which were on target. And I think if we can't score with 17 shots, then there's something seriously wrong. It really is. And it's so annoying because you're like, well, surely out of one of those chances you can finish it, and especially when two of them are gilt-edged opportunities like the Nonto and the Matteo Joseph ones, we should have scored either one of them. We really should. It's so disappointing because now if we'd have won that game, we'd have gone 3 points, we'd have gone top of the league, and we'd have gone 3 points clear of Burnley, who, let's be honest, Burnley are supposed to be one of our rivals this season. I don't think they were very good. I think they were very good at defending, let's say that, but going forward you could say, okay, well, they did what they needed to do, but without that slip and that goal coming from a mistake from us, what did they really create? And they didn't create much other than that, maybe that Zion Fleming shot in the first half where he was kind of wrestling with Joe Rodon and was able to take that shot into the bottom corner, which Melier was able to try and save, and he got there. But other than that, did they actually create much for themselves that we didn't just hand them on a silver platter? I don't think so. So I think, look, we've missed an opportunity today. I really do. At home against Burnley, who weren't that good, allowed us a lot of the ball. I think we've missed a big opportunity for 3 points. Not just 1 point, 3 points, because we had the chances to make it 3-1 in that first half. If you include a penalty that should have been given to us but wasn't. So I'm very disappointed. I am very disappointed in that game. Leeds just need to be better in the next one. They just have to be better. And like I said, I did a video the other day talking about the next few games. Kind of Leeds United will get this many points from the next few games. And I think the next one is, let me have a look. I'm literally just going to look at the thumbnail. So we've got Cardiff City, Coventry, Norwich and Sunderland in the next few games. We've got to be better in terms of finishing. Creating chances, we were fine. I would like to see more of Ramazani. I would like to see more of Tanaka. Potentially some of Schmidt as well, because I thought when Farker made the sub for Firpo to come off, it was like, okay, well, yeah, Firpo's on a yellow card. He's been good, but he's on a yellow card, so you take him off. You bring on Byram, who, of course, like, look, I'm a Leeds fan. I love Byram, but you kind of want to see Schmidt come on. You want to see your new player come on and go, okay, well, let's see what Schmidt can do, because he's a little bit more of an attacking force than what Byram is. So substitutes were disappointing for me. The finishing was disappointing. And overall, I think we were the better side and we deserved to win the game, but we didn't. So what does that tell us then? We need to practice our finishing. We need to take our chances and we need to go into these next games with a similar attitude to what we had in the first half, but just take the bloody chances. Put the ball in the back of the net and we'll all be all right. Yeah, very frustrating day for me, but Leeds have gone 1-0 down to Burnley and not been able to recover it. So it's going to be, on to the next one where hopefully we pick up 3 points. But when you actually look at the record, I think in the past 14 games, including the end of last season, Leeds have only won 4 in 14 or something. So it's a really poor record. Farker needs to turn it around and sharpish. Thanks for watching Leeds Lately, though. Hopefully it's a little bit more upbeat in the next one.